Today we're going to be cooking Viking food, and one of the recipes are cooking meat in pit. For the first, what you need is dig a pit and put lay of hand-sized stones on the bottom as well on the sides, and get a big fire. The fire should be on for 1.5–2 hours. Let's see what we get next. That's the first recipe of meat cooking in pit. For that we will need oil, garlic, pepper, salt, mustard seeds, dill with dry garlic and cumin, normal dill and some local herbs. You marinate everything in one and keep it for at least 12 hours in the fridge. Later on we would wrap it in leaves and cover with clay and place it in a pit, but we will show it later on. That's the second recipe of meat cooking in pit. For that we will need garlic, dill, pepper, salt, grounded mustard, honey, dry dill and garlic and cumin. Mix everything up, leave it for 12 hours in the fridge, then wrap it in leaves and put it in clay. That's the first recipe of meat cooking in pit. For that we will need garlic, dill, pepper, salt, dry garlic with dill, cumin, sour cream. In this case you can use yogurt as well. There are dry leeks and dry carrots, as well as cranberries. Unfortunately, I don't have them here, but they are in the recipe. Mix everything up, leave for 12 hours in the fridge, and wrap it up in leaves and clay before putting it in pit. That's the way how to wrap the meat inside the leaves. That's how it looks when it's already wrapped, and we will show later on how to put the clay on the top. There's something you have to know about the leaves. You're supposed to be taking away the stalks. If you don't do that, then the top layer that you put would poke through. So therefore, in order to make it more soft and comfortable, we cut off the leaf stalks. Now we're gonna be taking a piece of meat, clay, and start forming it approximately 1 centimeter around. There is a simple normal clay, it's nothing special. You just form it around. Enough, enough. No, not so thick. Make sure you close all corners around, and there's no any big pieces of clay peeping out. I like to leave the leaves on the top and put the meat in the pit with the leaves, as that would be much more comfortable to handle the things out. Today we will be making curd sauce that would go to the meat that we are cooking in a pit. For that we would need the garlic, dill, salt, pepper, yogurt or sour cream, and curd. So we just chop everything up, mix it in one piece, and then it would be done.
Yeah.